Very good morning. ASEA replacement alternatives. In this lecture, I will be discussing about the C. elegans as an experimental animal model. So, if you take what is meant by replacement alternatives, the exchange and the use of information about the animal's experiment, which is already carried out, the prediction of the activity based on the physicochemical properties of the molecule, or by using the mathematical and the computer modeling, or use of lower organisms which is not protected by any legislation, for example the C. elegans, or use of in vitro methods like usage of cell culture, or the use of early developmental stages before they become protected, example chicken embryo. So, as a part of replacement alternatives, and this lecture deals about the C. elegans as an experimental animal model. So, this is the fluorescent image of C. elegans. The C. elegans, which has proven instrumental in providing insight into the molecular mechanism of biological processes such as cell death, cell cycle, sex determination. It also contributed to our understanding of human neurodegenerative disorders, cancer, and aging, etc. Now, what is the advantages of the C. elegans? If we see, this is an invertebrate model which contains fewer than 1,000 somatic cells. So, out of 1,000 somatic cells, 300 will be the neurons. So, it is highly suitable for the studies which is related with the neurons. This is very small in size, approximately 1 millimeter in length, 80 micrometer in diameters. So, the simple structure makes it suitable for in vivo screening. It is transparent, so it allows for direct observations of the cellular phenotype. A very simple nervous system makes it a good model for neuronal studies. The applications of C. elegans is it can be used to develop the drugs for the treatment of cancer and neurodegenerative disorders. I said it is very simple and easy to grow. It can be grown in a petri dish using the media which is used for the growth of the E. coli. These have a short life cycle. The life cycle is only 3 to 5 days at 20 degrees Celsius. The powerful genetic studies can be conducted, both the self-fertile as well as the cross-fertile. It is transparent and we can observe the dopaminergic neurons and the small iset 1 millimeter in length. Invariant cell lineage, it is, the anatomy and development is fully described. The genome of C. elegans is completely sequenced. RNA interference knockdowns can be performed. The stalks can be frozen and preserved. No expensive animal house cost. Said no need of IAEC approval. Very cheap to maintain. No biohazard at all. That means it is non-infective, non-pathogenic, and non-parasitic. And the large size of progeny is possible. So these are all the advantages of C. elegans as an experimental animal model. So, by using this C. elegans, we can easily perform the screening of drugs for anti-Parkinsonism activity. So, this nematode can be obtained as a gift from the College of Biosciences, University of Minnesota. The address is cgc@umn.edu. This anti-Parkinsonism activity can be screened by estimating the parameters such as a lifespan study. I said the lifespan is 3 to 5 days. Locomotion behavior, the movement of the C. elegans, the analysis of dopaminergic neurodegeneration by means of fluorescent microscope, stress resistance assay, parenchymal pumping assay, and hemotaxic assay. So these are all the 6 parameters that has to be studied for estimation of anti-Parkinsonism activity of test compounds by using the C. elegans. Now this is the movement of the C. elegans. You know, in Parkinsonism there will be a poverty of movement. Depending upon the movement of this C. elegans, we can say whether our test compound have anti-Parkinsonism activity or not. This is the pumping, and this parenchymal pumping will be more if your drugs have anti-Parkinsonism activity. And this C. elegans can also be used for the aging and the age-related diseases, for the screening of aging and the age-related diseases. Many different approaches being used in C. elegans aging field, in addition to genetic manipulations such as calorie restriction, hormonic treatment, evolutionary studies, and also the population studies. Thank you very much. We will be meeting again in next lecture.